In this video, we will see some objective type question and answers in combinational circuits. First question, the minimum number of two input NAND gates are required to realize a half adder is, that is 8 or 5 or 6 or 4. So, half adder is a combinational circuit which is to add two binary digits. The half adder which has two inputs A and B, two outputs sum and carry. Here two inputs digital circuits, if we have n inputs, there is 2 power n possible combinations. Here there is two inputs, so 4 possible combinations. 2 power 2, that is 4 possible combinations. Next we will write the truth table. This is input and this one is output. Two inputs A and B, possible combinations are 4, that is 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. Next, we have to find what is sum and carry. Before that, we should know the addition rule. That is 0 plus 0 means it produces sum 0 and carry 0. 0 and 1 means it produces sum 1, carry 0. 1 and 0 means it produces sum 1, carry 0, both are same. 1 and 1, if you have two 1s means it produces sum 0, carry 1. If we have three 1s, sum is equal to 1 and carry is equal to 1. This is the addition rule. Okay, use this addition rules here. A and B, 0, 0, so sum 0, carry 0. A 0, B 1, so sum 1, carry 0. 1, 0, so sum 1, carry 0. 1, 1. So sum 0, carry 1. Next, we have to write the Boolean expression for sum and carry. So to write the expression, first look at this column, that is in sum. Okay, here sum is equal to 1. Then check the input combination. Here A0, B1. So it can be taken as A bar B. The corresponding minterm is A bar B. Next one, A1, B0, so that is A, B bar. By using these two min terms, you can write the sum of product expression, which is the Boolean expression of this sum. Okay, so A bar B plus A, B bar, that is the sum expression. Next one, carry. So for that, you have to look this column. Here, carry is equal to 1 and the corresponding input is A1, B1. So the min term is AB. Okay. So this is the expression of carry. So carry is equal to AB. Now we got the expression of sum and carry. Next we have to find the number of NAND gates to implement this sum and carry. So I will tell you the simple trick. If your expression is sum of product. Okay. If your expression is sum of product. Okay, that is product 1 plus product 2 plus product 3, if your function is equal to, and you are going to implement this by using NAND gate. Okay, then to find the number of NAND gates, the formula is number of product terms plus 1. So here it involves 3 product terms. Here we need 4 NAND gates. The minimum number of NAND gate is equal to number of product terms plus 1 in that sum of product. Okay. So here in sum expression we have 2 product terms. So to implement sum we need 2 plus 1 NAND gate, that is 3 NAND gates. Okay. And for carry AB, which is AND operation, and we know that to implement AND, we need 2 NAND gates. Okay. So here we need 2 NAND gates. Okay. So totally 3 plus 2, 5 NAND gates. We need 5 NAND gates. The minimum number of NAND gates required is 5. Here we are not considering this B bar and A bar. We are taking that it is already available. Okay. We are not using NOT gate, separate NOT gate for B bar and A bar. So here the minimum number of NAND gate is 3 plus 2, that is 5. So option B is the correct one. Next question, a combination circuit is one in which the output depends on the dash. Actually, combination circuit output depends upon the present input only, or the combinations of present input only. Okay, so first option, input combinations at the time. At the time means present input. Okay, so I think it is a correct one. Okay, let us check the other options also. Second one, input combination and the previous output. Input combination is the correct, but it does not depends on previous output. Okay, next, input combination at the time and the previous input combination. So it is right, but it is wrong. That is previous input combination. Fourth option, present output and previous output. Both are wrong. Okay, it depends upon the present input only. In combination circuit, the output depends upon the present input. So next question, which number or code is added to an incorrect result obtained in BCD addition for correction purpose? BCD, binary coded decimal, in which each decimal digit is represented by 4-bit binary. Okay, so by means of 4 bits, you can represent from 0 to 9. 0 to 9 can be represented by 4-bit binary, that is BCD. Okay. Here actually the correct answer is you have to add 6 with that incorrect answer to get the correct BCD result. Okay, we will see one example. Okay, you are going to add 9 and 6, that is 9 plus 6 is 15. Okay, so you have to perform your BCD addition. So first you have to represent 9 by BCD, that is 1001, and 6, that is 0110. Okay, so the answer is 1111. You get 1111. It is a BCD number and it is also BCD, but you get 1111, which is not a BCD, because in BCD repression, maximum value is 1001. Okay, we can represent only from 0 to 9. If you want to write a BCD for 10 means, you have to use 8 bits. But here, 1111, which is not a valid BCD number. Okay, to convert this into a valid BCD number, you have to add binary 6 with this. Okay, let us check 1111. 6 is 0, 1, 1, 0, right? So 1 plus 0, 1. 1 plus 1, sum 0, carry 1. 1, 1, 1, 3, 1. So sum 1 carries also 1, right? 1, 1. So sum 0 and carry is 1. So you can place 1 here. Okay. So now split this into 4 digits. So first 4 digits 0101, that is 5. Okay, next one 1, you can put 3 more zeros. So 0001, that is 1. Okay, 15. So answer is 15 and the correct BCD value is 10101. This is the correct BCD. Okay.